my brother dies.
All earth was troubled.
You know, when he dies,
only you,
the way he died from a drug overdose,
you could know the pain.
I couldn't understand it,
right.
And it was eating me up.
Face the devil. We're no stranger to me.
I had a family, I had a wife, I had two kids, I had a house in Cinco Ranch. I was a vice president of this company. I was making six digits a year easily every year. You know, I had a boat, I had everything you could think of. It took me maybe 6 months to lose everything. I felt so bad about myself, I didn't care. I was taking penitentiary chances daily. I wasn't ever gonna stop unless I died or went to prison. And I ended up getting in trouble. Yeah, I got arrested. I stole a backhoe, a bulldozer valued at $250,000.
For what reason?
Because I didn't want to walk three blocks. I went to Open Door Mission for 8 months in a residential program. So I said, let me try their way, maybe it'll work. So I did, I committed to it and I did everything they said and I participated and it really did change my life.
These dockets provide a unique, individualized approach to people with longstanding addictions, criminal histories, nonviolent offenders who have been in the revolving door of criminal justice.
Today I have hope. Today I'm in contact and have seen and met again my children that I lost to my addiction and to adoption.
It holds them accountable, but you know the struggles that they're having, the obstacles they're facing, whether their child is flunking out of school, whether their mother passed away. It's a very unique approach. The point is to engage the person in treatment long enough where the light bulb goes off and they say, this is real and I want this for me.
Even in my first experience, I came in and they had just finished a graduation. And so I come into the court and everybody's smiling and laughing and there's star-shaped cookies and I thought, what is this? And there was a young lady who came up and spoke to my mom and she said, don't worry, mom, she's gonna be great. She's gonna do well. Yeah. And I just thought, wow, you know, I've never come into a court setting and been given hope. It was the most desperate time of my life. Now that I'm on the other side of it, all I want is to be able to show people that there is a way out.
We are a fundraising organization, and our money goes to help people directly who are in the STAR Drug Court program or they are graduates of it. We provide transitional housing, educational scholarships, vocational scholarships, as well as grief and trauma counseling. Also, in our big city, transportation is a nightmare, and so we pay for bus passes. We present our checks a lot of times at their graduation ceremonies because we want people in the program to know we're there and what we can help them with.
There's probably not a better thing that I can think of to give to because these are somebody's brother, somebody's son, somebody's husband.
Oh, how we cried the day you left us.
You know, it's a very heavy thing for not only your family, but everything that touches your family, you know?
And they